going to start with this networking event, what we have named PPCC19. Later on, we will explain to you the reason for this, but now is give you the welcome to this event and also to the Instituto Eduardo Torroja. I'm working here because of that I started. And we would like to start with one presentation that is related with the European project that covers all the topics we are going to analyze today with you. And this first presentation will come from the coordinator of the project. In this case is Monica Pilt. So Monica, we are waiting for you. And Monica, I would like to introduce her. Is, as I said, the Lorcenis coordinator. He's chemist and PhD from the 19th. And he has a long experience in material research and product development as project manager, laboratory manager, and research development manager at the Research Institution for Applied Science and a medium-sized chemical system, construction materials. And at a startup, Enterprise Germany, since 2007, she has been senior research scientist of SINTEF. SINTEF is an organization like the CSIC, but in Norway. She is also in Oslo, in Norway, working with materials and nanotechnology and collaborating as project manager with industrial and academic partners on both national and international levels. And from 2017, she graduated at the Norwegian Business School at Oslo in Norway, and currently Monica Pilt is the technical coordinator of the H2020 project, Lorcenis. That is the topic she is going to address now. Thank you, Monica.
Thank you very much, Maria, for this kind introduction and also for organizing this workshop with such a big audience. You mobilized to join us for today. And you prepared this workshop together with your local organizing team in Madrid here with SICA and Acciona, and your own team here is CSIC Institute. So thank you very much for that. So my task today is to introduce you to Lorcenis. And as Maria pointed out, Lorcenis is a Horizon 2020 project and receive funding from the European Commission. Lorcenis stands for long-lasting reinforced concrete for energy infrastructures under severe operation conditions. And the workshop today is one of our important dissemination activities in this project. The background for Lorcenis is that there is an increasing demand of energy worldwide in the coming 30 years as the population is steadily growing. And therefore, new infrastructure projects need to require longer service life spans, service lifetimes, and materials that perform in more and more extreme operation conditions. We are moving more to the north, to the Arctic and subarctic areas. We are moving more to the south, to desert areas. We locate such energy infrastructures along coastlines and also at deep sea. So the objective of Lorcenis is to develop long-lasting reinforced concrete for energy infrastructures with lifetime extended up to 100% under extreme operation conditions. The partners we grouped in Lorcenis, we mobilized in Lorcenis, is a consortium of well-balanced multidisciplinary experts. 16 partners we are in Lorcenis, 9 partners coming from universities and research institutes, as shown here in this column, and 7 industrial partners, including 2 SMEs, small and medium enterprises, and 5 big players in Europe, coming from the material supplier side, but also from the end user sites. That means they are building the energy infrastructures here in Europe. The ambition in Lorcenis is to consider 4 scenarios for infrastructure of energy infrastructures in severe operation conditions. And in scenario one, we grouped a selection of infrastructures that are located at the cold climate, and they will suffer from ice impact, ice abrasion, corrosion due to salt loading, thaw properties, and they are also located at deep sea, as here the gravity-based structures. So we have also bridges, water dams in this scenario. In scenario two, we consider mechanical fatigue, and this is mainly in windmills, in the concrete windmill towers, onshore and offshore. And scenario three, we define as infrastructures exposed to high temperature gradients, like for example, centered solar power plants, or storage tanks for LNG. And in the fourth scenario, we are considering energy infrastructures, for example, cooling towers or sewage plants, which are suffering acidic attack, and the durability of such concrete structures are limited by the acidic corrosion. LOCSENIS is a research and innovation action. That means the development of the development stage is starting as a TRL, technical readiness level of 3. That means we are starting with a proof of concept in the lab, and then we advanced to the validation of the technical validation in the lab and in relevant environment, advancing from technical readiness level 3 to 5. And here is the main property we are screening is the durability of the advanced reinforced concrete structures that will be validated in the lab in real environment. And as you will see, we also advance these technical readiness levels to demonstration in real relevant environment, but also with a system prototype demonstrator in an operational environment. In LOCSENIS, we are passing several research and innovation stages, and the concept is based on the optimal combination of novel technologies. The novel technologies are nanostructured materials with self-responsive ability towards severe conditions, and we are meaning here self-diagnosis to induce self-healing to the concrete structures to enable self-curing or to give self-protection properties to reinforced concrete structures. In the first step, it was necessary to look at the compatibility of such nanostructured material with the cement formulation, with mortar and with concrete, in order to be able to prepare test specimens which will were exposed to laboratory test procedures under accelerated conditions. So in these durability analysis, we made a selection of the most promising technologies, which then had to be considered for upscaling in order to provide larger amounts of such nanostructured materials for larger specimen, as we plan also the demonstration activities. In addition, the sustainability aspects and the cost-efficient operation aspect were analyzed by the LCA and LCC, also life cycle analysis and life cycle cost analysis, and the whole picture of LOCSENIS is completed by a multi-scale modeling development in order to predict the service life of LOCSENIS concrete structures. these activities were grouped into 5 work packages, put into a framework of additional work package dealing with the exploitation and the dissemination and the project management. So in the approach in Los Angeles is to implement the multifunctional response strategies into concrete structures by implementing such nanostructured materials in concrete in order to improve the durability of such structures under severe operation conditions. That means under self-diagnosis, to implement self-diagnosis properties into concrete structures, we have this as a predictive action, and you will find this also as a topic in your workshop program. It's to insert the property of cell sensing of mechanical stress, starting due to external mechanical load, due to alteration and at the operation conditions. As a latent corrective actions, we look at self-healing, introducing self-healing into the concrete structures by the nanostructured materials in order to induce self-repairs of initial cracks and by that also to improve the durability. As preventive actions, we are considering the self-curing and the self-protection in order to mitigate the autogenous shrinkage of in a very early stage of the concrete structures, but also to lower the permeability and by that also to decrease the chloride ingress into the concrete structures and to reduce the chloride transport to the rebars, to the reinforcement of the concrete, and by that to protect such reinforcements against corrosion. In parallel, we are also developing numerical tools in order to capture the evolution of the damage in such concrete structures at a multiscale. And the multiscale is starting at the atomistic scale and then involving the microscale observation and the mesoscale and up to the macroscale. For this showcase, which is concrete structures in highly corrosive environments like here in a harbor site. And this modeling activities is done in order to predict the service life of such concrete structures in this harsh environments. Los Angeles passes several decision stages where we selected the most promising multifunctional strategies developed and integrated into the concrete formulations and the selection of the advanced stable bulk concretes based on the optimized binder systems. And we started from the project start up to now. We are now in month 36, so we have still 1 year to go, 12 months to go until the project end, and we are now in the middle of the demonstration activities. And we are testing 12 prototypes. They were designed in order to get validated and demonstrated under relevant industrial conditions. That means TRL 5 and 6, and you find such demonstrators with self-responsive technologies for dedicated scenario types. And in one case, we have also a large-scale demonstrator exposed to operational conditions, that means as a technical readiness level of 7. So this now during the next 12 months, not years, of course we would like to test it 12 years because then we really will see durability changes. But in the next 12 months, we will monitor this in a one-step monitoring, that means validation at the end of the demonstration activities and or stepwise during the next months. The target of Loch Sénis, the overall target, is to reduce the lifespan and to increase the lifespan and to reduce the maintenance cost. And we see for the several technologies in the several scenarios we selected that the self-diagnosis is mainly considering the to reduce the maintenance cost, whereas we cannot expect that self-diagnosis technologies will increase the lifespan in a large to a large extent. But the self-protection, here we expect that we have a big influence on to the on the maintenance costs, and of course also combined with increased lifespan. Whereas self-healing and self-curing will have a more moderate effect on both lifespan and maintenance cost. So in a summary, I would like to share with you some knowledge we gained during the Loch Sénis, during the 36 months of project time. So we developed and implemented multifunctional strategies, which we integrated into formulations of bulk reinforced concrete. And here we optimize and upscale such self-responsive approaches by tailoring such technologies in order to really meet compatibility with the concrete formulations. We also developed advanced stable bulk concretes in order to extend the service life in the harsh environmental conditions. And here we designed several concrete mix designs, and we came up with two top concrete technologies, the self-compacting concrete and the ultra-high performance concretes, which now have been further functionalized with self-responsive nanostructured materials. We implemented such approaches to the bulk concrete. And we made a ranking of the level of self-responsiveness on the individual properties we selected for the different scenarios. And this is based on our durability testing we made at lab scale. So here the real change was to show the added value of such multifunctional self-responsive materials, because we already started with a high durable concrete formulation, the SCC and the UHPC. We also realized, or we are in about to realize, the multi-scale showcase towards the service life prediction. And we started by transferring the metadata structure with the relevant parameters for modeling the aggressive ions in the bulk concrete. And we described the several model approaches, the atomistic, micro, meso, and macro scale models for the degradation phenomena of chloride ingress in bulk concrete. And now we are about to link these models into a full chain, a multi-scale modeling, in order this will be then finally validated as a technical readiness of 5, finally validated for the service life prediction of this of the environment of high aggressive ions, as for example in the exposure site of the harbor. We also now are about to prove and validate the durability of the sustainable advanced reinforced concrete prototypes in the different scenarios. And here we reached TL5, as I showed you, but also in some scenarios, some exposure sites, we are going beyond this technical readiness level of 5. So we are beyond this original plans. So the main impact we are expecting from Lorsenes are based on the reduced maintenance cost and extended service life for in the energy sector. And this is by the increased sustainability of the energy infrastructures, because reducing of repair cycles and reduced risk of accidents due to a material failure will support this and increase this sustainability aspects. And by this, we are in the middle of the workshop. It's a good starting point for the topics Maria has chosen for this workshop. And I would like to invite you to take part in all the discussions. And we are very pleased to have you here for today. So thank you very much for your attention, and I wish you to have a successful innovation networking today. Thank you.